Previously on Marty and Melvin.
Check it out, Fez here! Fez!
There's a DJ called White Wolf. He always used to wear Trilby, and some say when he was making a pasta bake that half his face got smothered with pesto and it boiled him alive.
It was QB.
Let go of it! I'm done with you now, Fez! I'm after you, Fez!
White Wolf is coming.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let
fantastic.
It
snow. Merry Christmas at the B&B.
And I've brought me some corn for pop.
Mervyn, what are the you doing?
Decorating.
Decorating? Decorating for what exactly? Kiss
good night. Easter, Marty! I'm the breadsticks! Well, Marty, it's Christmas, obviously!
Melvin! Christmas guests are here!
Righto, boss!
Money for the orphans.
Fuck off! warms my heart to see things like that.
Did you give those carol singers some money?
Oh, yes. That's a nice candle you got there, Marty.
Oh, thank you, Melvin. It was only $2.99 from the pound shop. Melvin. Melvin!
What is it?
Melvin, look! Look, it's... Melvin, wait. I could have sworn that I saw...
What are you talking about, Marty? Must have been a dream. You know, I had a dream once. I was a weasel that won the Tour de France.
Haven't you already used that joke before?
Oh shit, have I? I'll get the dinner on. Ah, wunderbar.
Oh! Don't you think you're going a little bit overboard with these Christmas decorations?
Why do you hate Christmas so much?
Father, when do I get that hat that I wanted for Christmas?
You mean when I went to that brothel when you were six and cheated on your mother? Or the time I ran over your pet dog, Woofy, with the Land Rover? That was bloody mess. Or the time it was your 16th birthday and you took your girlfriend to the prom and I shagged her? Or the time... It was Christmas time again, last year, but I blew up the house and claimed an insurance claim on Esau. Oh, at the time, you were having a bath and I drove the toaster in. This hat? Yes, this one.
But Dad, I'm only 7 years old. I don't even have a prom date yet.
Well, I'm going to. You didn't have responsibility like the hat. Like the time you made me win the lottery. Or the time you left the milk out. Or the time you ran over my foot and pretended to be Jewish. All the time when I was Abraham Lincoln and I had the short sword and the shortbread. All the time I tried
to find Jesus, and Jesus wouldn't want me to because he was on the end of the Bakerloo line. All the time, I tried to find the stairs, but you were underneath them, and I couldn't find them. And I shouted out, Marty! Marty! No, no, no! All the time I'm leaving now, and I'm leaving you forever, I'm not going to come back. All the time I love your friend instead of you. Or all the other times that I tried to answer the phone and you would not pick it up! All the time I tried to play banjo and all the other instruments in the world. All the time I plugged in the stereo and played Really Love Music to Vodilay and you didn't even care.
Yeah, yeah. Can I have that hat then, please?
No! I'm giving to the Uncle Derek.
Ah, Uncle Dave's in the house! I'm just joking, Marty. There you go. I'm going.
Where's the roll for this sausage?
Well, I don't know.
I don't get it! Huh? Oh.
You're an idiot, Melvin.
What? The snow?
I can't take this anymore, Melvin. It's not safe to be here. We need to ring FBI relocation immediately.
No, don't worry, I've got them on speed dial 4. Yeah, I know, Lucy. Like a snake. Now put Roy back on. Yeah. Hi, Roy. Yes, well, Marty's been a bit frightened again by all these weird things that go on every season. Yeah, I watch it as well. Yeah. Yeah, well, we were thinking that we might need to move house, you know, get somewhere that's not so, you know, dangerous from this white moth bloke. I mentioned him before. White moth. Yes. Oh, he's your most wanted, is he? Oh. Very nice. Well, yeah, okay. Well, yeah, come round whenever you want, really. We're not doing anything. We're really not doing anything. Cheers, Roy. Bye.
Hello, Melvin. I'm sure you remember me. This is my associate, Lieutenant Carpet.
Reynolds Maxwell.
And Captain White.
Hello there!
Ah, Agent Maurice, yes, of course I remember you. You chased away that horrible Mexican, didn't you? Oh, well, do come in.
Sosa, what a Captain Beeper.
Yes!
Smells like semen in here. Smells like sea bass.
Smells like dildos!
Why are you wearing that bike helmet?
Oh, this? Oh, I've been practicing safe sex.
No, he wasn't.
Marty, get your ass in here. Something needs to be done about this.
Funny, I think we should just give them up to the white moth. Think about it, we should sympathise with him. He really wants these two little chickens.
I don't do that.
We should send them to Tropical Island, a population of all women.
Melvin doesn't like women.
Oh, is that right, Marty? That's what I found under your bed. Gay for pay? You filthy faggot.
Don't
There's no need for names. Let's go on to the nitty-gritty.
Well, we could send you to Jerusalem and look after goats, or we could send you down the road.
Well, I suppose down the road's not too bad.
Well, that's settled then. We shall only trust one of the agents with the address. Now, who shall I choose?
Pick me! I can do this!
Ah, Richard, love,
he's a person that I can't count to!
I'll try the address down. There we go.
Cold in here, and you're sitting on my knee.
But you're sitting on my knee. Ooh, now.
How does that work?
Down, you lovers.
We haven't even left the house yet.
All right.
I'm tempted to shoot you both and get this over and done with.
Oh yeah. Bring it on. This is taking forever.
Must be White Moth causing all this traffic.
You would say that, wouldn't you?
How do you know White Moth is to blame?
Oh, come on, Lieutenant Carpet.
I'm trying, okay? I've already passed 3 days ago.
Oh.
What did we recruit you for, then?
Yeah, no clue.
Fucking hell! Fuck!
There's no need to
swear. We're never gonna get to the house.
Look, I've got to stop at the garage to get some Pringles. Do you mind?
Get me some.
Ready salted, please.
Oops,
I like a Kinder Bueno.
Kinder Bueno.
A Solero for me.
I know it's
a bit cold, but...
Not long, no longer.
The problem I have sitting back here is that there's not enough room for my erection.
Oh, I'd say there is.
I knew you'd like that one, Melvin.
Shut up. You're being stuck. Oh, it's not messy in here.
Whose bright idea was it to put the window down?
Stevie got the
head. Where's the window?
You're sitting on my seatbelt.
What? It's weather. Pretty bad, isn't it?
Mothwatch, you're rather quiet. Are you tickling your anus again?
No, sir. I'm just thinking about how I'm going to look after these two people in the house.
Keep thinking about that.
I will.
I feel really safe in this car.
Bob's my best man. I'm just glad we're away from that horrible white mob.
Thank
no
you,
more scares
Papa.
For him, right, Melvin?
Right there, Martin.
Don't worry, we never miss a trick. White Moth won't be able to get anywhere near you.
Yep, anywhere
it's not
near
like you can share a car.
And how ironic that it's snowing white.
Oh,
that's after you.
Yes.
But it doesn't snow any other colour, does it?
Not pink.
Oh, this is the new place then.
Oh, this is it. Wow. Better than RV.
Hello, boys.
I
like
boys.
Going boys.
I'm
Reynolds, someone behind you all. From my point of view.
Alright, yes. If you say so. Oh, Marcy, move it.
Don't rush me, Melvin.
I want to get inside. I'm fucking.
Well, come on in. This is your new house. As you can see, it's fully furnished. Everything's in here that you need.
Quite stuffy, isn't it? I like that. Yeah. I think you'll be at home here.
Very nice. What do you think, Robin?
I like it much more than the D&B. I think it's crap.
Oh! You should go to bed.
Well, I guess we should, yes.
You've had a long day, and you've got a long day ahead of you.
It's been quite tiring, all that packing up, and we've got to unpack in the morning, so...
If you need anything, don't ask us.
Thanks for that.
Well, I'll sleep in this room, and you can sleep the one at the end.
Yeah, that's fine.
Great. Good night, Marty.
Sounds like I've got people in your room. Shut that up.
Oh, yeah.
Then the Russian came up to me and goes, "Look, don't kill me, I'm innocent." And
excuse me. guys,
what he's did. Oh, Marty.
Melvin, actually.
Marty, but Melvin.
Don't try out on that, okay? Just get out of my room, I want to go to sleep. You go downstairs and make sure that guy doesn't come in here, alright?
We'll guard the room.
So then I pulled my toe out, and it went everywhere.
I see.
Vaseline makes you slippery.
It does indeed. So does balsamic vinegar.
Yes,
it does.
Mm-hmm.
Does indeed.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
Whoopsie. Oh well, better get into the barn.
Oh, what was that noise? Where's Melvin?
You're not too sure. Oh no,
there's a note. He seems to have got walkies.
Hang on a second.
Oh, it turns out that Melvin has been taken by the white moth.
What? The white moth? How did he follow us here?
Cargo balls and blasts. It also turns out that white moth was our old agent, Moth White.
It's awfully hard to spot these double agencies.
Shit. We buggered up again.
Well, you can sit here doing nothing, and I'm going to go and rescue Melvin.
It's hopeless. We couldn't find her. We couldn't find him anywhere. Jamaica, Wario Land, Cuba.
Where you got the hat?
Yes, yes, I like my new hat.
Yeah, better than his hat.
Why do you know this is an Atlanta original, this hat? Also, you should come up here. There's lemmings everywhere!
I say we try Honduras and then Pakistan after that.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Just look in there, anomalous goals.
Stop that sin! Oh, dear friend, Mom, I get you. I'm going to kill your family and kill you both. There, here. Time for this moth to fly.
Basically, Melvin's never done anything for me. So, well, I see it. He dies. That's competition for great Uncle Milgrid's big merger. It was wise for me. So I'm pissing off. I want my suitcase of crack cocaine so I can sell that and go and eat a Cosmo. So piss off and give me that suitcase. See you later, losers!
Whoa.
What a wanker.
What on earth is that?
Gosh, are you okay?
Why, yes. I am, laddie.
Hey, perhaps this guy could help us.
He looks like he definitely knows a lot.
Hey, I do.
I think it's time to go to the barn now, guys.
Hey, I joined you. I'm a bit pissed off, eh?
Melvin! Melvin!
This is my chance to be the hero.
What the hell is that?
I don't believe it. What am I doing? I don't even live here. What the fuck?
Help. What the hell?
Oh my God, he's taking him out.
Michael, in there! You have to rescue me.
It's Marty, you fool.
Oh, Marty. Oh, slightly disappointing, but thanks anyway. Yes, it feels good to be out of that. Oh, Marty. I don't know, that's very nice.
Lovely.
I do, but I don't understand why.
Shut up,
Melvin. I've got out of trouble here. It's White Moth. Run, Marty. You can't escape that easily, boys.
Use the kettle, Melvin.
What? Moth pain.
Good job, Melvin.
You guys are dead! Once my brain starts shaking. Oh. I'm being angry! Church. The only place that White Moth can be destroyed.
Come on.
Hurry, Marty, hurry. Marty! All because David Tennant stopped being Doctor Who. He was a good bloody actor.
What a cat sphinxster, what a twat! Hey, he didn't buy the car anyway! I said to him, you are the Guinness, drink that! But no, he said no! Anyway...
God, you're alive!
Man. Pretty lucky, wasn't it?
Yeah. Good to see you again, Marty.
You too, Melvin.
You too.
Marty, how are we gonna get home?
She was into the stones when I was into the roses. She was breaking my bones when I was bursting their noses. She would tell me a secret, I would lose it the next day. Your love pleases you easy, makes you sick in a bad way.
We'll be right back.
Just